inability to speak up for yourself, inability to say your thoughts, your ideas, your opinion. Today we're gonna do a Q&A video. I received a question from one of my viewers like you, and I received it by email. So if you have a question that you would like to ask, feel free to send me an email at info@elenasemenak.com, or better, send it, write it in the comments below this video on YouTube or below any other videos on my YouTube channel. And the more likes I get on your question, the higher chance that I will create a video answer for you. So today's question came from Abdullahi or Abdullahi. I'm sorry, I probably pronounced it incorrectly. So please let me know in the comments if you know how to pronounce your name, or if you know how to pronounce this name, if it's not your name. So the question is, hi, I have some personal problems, like fear of presentations, and I am unable to answer questions when people ask me, even though I know the answer. I get nervous and start shaking. What can I do to overcome this? Please advise. Thank you for the excellent question, and thank you for being open. Thank you for sharing your story with me. Thank you for your trust. So what you are describing is called prohibition. So you have some type of taboo inside of yourself that is not allowing you to speak up. I believe that this taboo came from your parents, or maybe from a person who was a caregiver in your childhood. I made this conclusion, on this assumption, based on your bodily reaction. You wrote that you get nervous and start shaking. So this is a very, very strong reaction, and I cannot ignore it. This is not a normal fear of being afraid of public speaking. This is not a normal fear or discomfort of being afraid to say no. This is a very, very strong feeling, and these feelings immobilize you. You cannot physically speak up. You cannot physically to say an answer, even though you know it. So this is a very important point. You know the answer, but you feel shaking, you feel nervous, and you cannot say it. Please look closer to the situations where you feel this and pay attention to your body. Your body will give you a clue. Your body will give you the key to the origin of this issue. Notice first, do you feel the same reaction when you talk to people older than you, same age as you, and younger than you? If you feel this reaction only with people who are older than you, then probably it came from your childhood. 99% that it came from your childhood. If you feel that it's happening with your or with the people the same age of you, then probably it relates to the relationship with your siblings. So notice, I don't think that you feel these feelings when you're talking to a child who is younger than you, right? So the chance is very, very small. Probably you feel this with the people who have some type of authority, like teachers, your boss, people who are older than you, and you know that they have some high social status. Then notice the gender of that person, of these people. So you need to do some diagnostic or analysis on yourself. So if you know that usually you feel what you describe with people older than you, then notice if it's the same feelings with male and or female. And if you know that usually you feel, taboo of speaking up with your teacher who's a woman who is 20 years older than you, then look closer to your relationship with your mom. So probably your mother placed or created this taboo of speaking up. And when I say taboo, I mean that every time when you were a little, when you were trying to share your thoughts, your ideas, first of all, you were ignored. Nobody treat your ideas as valid ideas. Probably you were criticized and maybe people laughed at your ideas. And maybe they even, you know, say something like, I know better, you don't have a voice, so you don't have the right to talk, I'm your mom, you know, you're gonna do what I say, I don't care what you said. You don't have a right to make a decision. You don't have a right to decide. It's gonna be the way I said it, it's gonna be. So look at different situations when you felt the same feelings, and again, pay attention to your body, because your body is not gonna lie. And once you get some ideas, already it should ease an intention of your feelings. So once you know that, let's say, this taboo came from my dad, so when you're gonna talk to another person, to a teacher at school or to your boss, you can tell yourself, he's not my dad, he's my boss. He's not my dad, he's my teacher. He's not my dad, he's just an older gentleman. So you can help your mind, your brain, to separate your present from your past. But in order for you to work on your past, because your past is like kind of haunting you, right? So in order for you to truly work on this issue, of course you need somebody professional. You need a therapist, you need a mentor, you need a person who can help you to guide through your feelings. This is not an easy situation. There is no quick fix. There is no easy way. You need to talk to somebody about your past. You need to go through your feelings. You need to do some exercises. And you need to heal your inner child, so your childhood emotions are not gonna interrupt and overwhelm you when you need to speak up for yourself. Again, thank you very much for your question. And please, guys, write thank you in the comments, because I encourage people to be open. I know it's not easy to speak up about our challenges. It's sometimes people feel ashamed and discomfort when they ask me a question, especially when I do the answer publicly. I can imagine what Abdullah is going through right now, but you are very brave, and I am here to support you. So let's support him together. Let's say thank you for sharing your story in the comments. And please give this video likes to support me, to support Abdullahi, and ask your questions. I would like to hear from you. I would like to help you, and share this video with your friends, with your family, on your social networks. Please help me to help you and other people to find this video and to ask their questions, because together we can help each other to grow and to heal our traumas. Follow me on Instagram, on Facebook, and check out my website. If you subscribe to my newsletters, you will receive seven free guided meditations and seven exercises, and every week you will receive new tools, new mini articles, and new videos from me that will help you to work on your inner trauma at your home. And of course, consider coming to my private sessions and my online group therapy, as well as online courses. All the information is below. Check out the links. Thank you for watching. See you next time. Bye.